Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair. In today's video guys, we're going to cover the top 10 reasons. 10 reasons why your AC does not work. So if your air conditioner does not work, whether it's a BMW, Ford, Mercedes right there guys, the procedure will be about the same, how to test things and what to look for. So let me explain quick, okay. 10 reasons why the AC doesn't work. But the most common one, top one will be you don't have enough Freon in the system or you have a leak somewhere. And you can test that, okay, usually you can test it with a, you can see with a can, if you have a can with a mode, with a meter right here, pressure meter, most of them come like that. We'll have the links in the description of the video. And we need to locate the low pressure side, okay, low pressure port, and this is a high pressure port. The low one is a little bit smaller in most cases. Okay, we're going to connect it, wear eye protection glasses, all that stuff. You can see we have enough pressure with the car not running. So we have Freon in the system. We are going to demonstrate how it's going to start going down once the system starts working. Another thing will be always check you need to check the fuse. Okay, let me open the fuse box quick. For the AC clutch. The AC clutch is a magnetic clutch and it needs a fuse that turns it on and off. And if the fuse is burned, guys, okay, what's going to happen actually? It will not perform right. In our case, it's this fuse right here. You have to check your manual. If we have the car, we will make the video for you to show you exactly which fuse it is. Next one will be the AC clutch will actually have a relay. One of the relays most likely in the engine compartment will be for the AC clutch relay. And okay, so far we covered 3 reasons, but now we get to the reasons that are not so obvious. Number 4 guys, if your fan, okay, does not work, if your fan doesn't work, your AC will not work on most modern vehicles. And this is because it does that so it doesn't overheat the engine. And again, we go back, okay, to the fan fuse. So you have to check fan fuse, you have to check fan relay. In our case, that big relay is for the fan. Another thing, guys, is the clutch itself. And you can usually test clutch. Okay, we'll have another video how to test the clutch. But you can see this is the AC compressor on this Ford Fiesta. Okay, I'm trying to focus right there. So this AC clutch, okay, come on, cooperate with me. Okay, you can see right there, this is the clutch on the bottom right here. And you can test them to see if it's bad, but most likely this is a very common reason as well. And often the compressors do not go bad, but just the clutch goes bad. And you can replace clutch way cheaper than replacing the whole compressor. Again, it could be a bad compressor too. We had a Volkswagens and a Honda with bad compressors. They didn't build enough pressure and it wasn't getting things cool. Okay, another thing is you have a valve for the pressure somewhere. You have a pressure sensor on one of the lines. And ours is under the headlight here. I will not be able to show you. You have to remove the headlight. And this is called a pressure switch. What it does actually, it reads the pressure from the AC system, and if it has enough pressure, it turns the compressor on and it starts cooling the air. So that could be bad as well. Another thing guys, it could be the switch itself. And most likely the switch, sometimes it has its own fuse too. For instance, on this Ford Fiesta, the fuse is behind the glove box. But if the climate control doesn't work, the AC will not work, and this switch, it's very often to go bad. So there is a way to test them, and we'll cover that as well in another video, how you can test AC switch. But what you can actually do, the top 10 reason, actually your AC works, but you don't know that it works. And how that happens? It's usually you have a flap, okay, in the dash that opens the cold and hot air vent. So you know, when you switch it to hot air, that flap closes one side and opens another one. But if the flap motor is not working or the cable is not working, some are manual, some are power, you might be getting hot air and the AC running, but you will not get cold air. And I'm going to go ahead now. Okay, I'll start the car. Okay, with the AC on, and I'm going to show you how the clutch will be spinning first. Okay, you can see it'll start cooling things down pretty quick here. Okay, let me get it. Okay, on this side right here. Okay, you can see that knock right here. That's our flap actually making noise there. It's getting stuck. And that's the one that controls to go to the windows or towards you. You can see, and our AC is working. But now, stay with us. I want to show you a few more major things to look for. Okay, you can see the temperature keep dropping, and it will keep dropping even more. I want to show you how the AC clutch will be spinning, but you have to always be careful and be out of the way. Let me just show you the clutch quick, and we'll show you one more trick. Okay, you can see the clutch on the bottom. It's spinning now. Okay, so it's engaged. Another thing now, you have to be very careful not to get caught by the fan or anything like that, but one of the pipes will be a hot pipe and one will be freezing cold. This one is freezing cold, and I'll demonstrate you, okay? Okay, with the thing here, that this is at 60 degrees. I don't know if I'll be able to do this one. This one is at 80. And that's just running for a little bit of time. We're going to test the pressure now. I will not recommend connecting it while the car is running. But just to show you, now with the running, it will be in the green. Okay, and right now you can see we have it in the green at 40 PSI. So those are, guys, the top 10 reasons why your AC doesn't work. And it's really hard to know which one it is, but you have to start diagnosing one by one. Okay, and you can see the other pipe is actually dropping even more, 40 degrees. And if you do this one here, it's even less now. You can see it's going to hit on this side. If you get it right here, it's probably going to get in the 30s somewhere. Yep, 37. And on this side, okay, we have in the 80s. So hopefully the video is helpful, guys. Thank you for watching, and many more to come.